What's up, everybody? This is Brian Mazeek. We are talking today about the blockbuster three-team trade that went down. Basically, the Cleveland Cavaliers acquired from the New York Knicks, J.R. Smith and Iman Shumpert. Deion Waiters went from the Cleveland Cavaliers to the Oklahoma City Thunder. Now, the Thunder actually didn't have to part with very much. They part with Lance Thomas, who obviously is a more or less pretty much a role player. So they didn't have to really give up too much, but the Cavs actually also had to send rookie center Alex Kirk and forward Lua Munson and a 2019 second round pick to the Knicks. So the Knicks, I mean, it's pretty much clearly a salary dumping situation for them. They're basically dropping the $6.4 million that they owe to J.R. Smith for next season, and they're trying to clear cap space. Trying to make a run at top-notch free agents in the future. I mean, in a season right now where they've won five games, it's hard to complain about any move that they're doing, especially if it's a cost-cutting move. So dumping Smith makes sense. Iman Shumpert's injured right now, but he's expected to be back shortly. So there's that. Smith and Shumpert, they can both actually help Cleveland, in my opinion. Smith is going to probably embrace that six-man role more than Deion Waiters did, and he has more facets to his game when he's actually plugged in. Now, because I've watched JR at times throughout his career, and I'm talking about back to, you know, Denver, maybe not with New Orleans or with the Hornets, but back with Denver, throughout his career, proved that he could create off the dribble for himself and his teammates. I've also seen him finish at the rim and play above average defense. If he commits to playing the right way and rolling with LeBron, I think he might. The Cavs could actually have a steal in this deal. I mean, because J.R. Smith is extremely talented. It's just about staying. J.R. Smith is very similar, in my opinion, to Josh Smith. He's just like a smaller version. If they play under control, they're among the best at their position, really. Now, Shumpert is already a solid defender. His jump shot isn't quite good enough for him to ever be like a premier offensive player. But as a physical and big guard, he can be very valuable as a defender and a finisher in transition, which is something he should probably get opportunities to see playing alongside Kyrie Irving and LeBron James. So I expect to see him ultimately move into the starting role with JR coming off the bench. So all that said, though, this still doesn't actually resolve Cleveland's biggest issue, which is interior defense. This team is in some desperate need of a rim protector. That's why you're hearing them involved in trade rumors about Timofey Mozgov. There's Greg Monroe talk out there. I mean, I'm sure they probably had some interest in Jermaine O'Neal, even though he's probably going to end up going to Dallas. But there's a lot of talk out there because it's really a big man is what they really need the most. Now, I do think this move helps them, but a big man is what they need the most because interior defense is the biggest problem. Now, maybe there's another deal coming down the pike for them, a signing or a deal that would be made in the next month or two so that they can address that. But until they address that, I can't see them really giving the Bulls or Toronto or Atlanta. I think all of those teams would probably beat Cleveland in a playoff series because of the deficiencies inside, and that's even with LeBron James and Kyrie. Now, as for Waiters landing in OKC, it looks great on a video game, but I'm wondering how this is going to work in real life, because he's not like the same type of player that James Harden was back when he played with OKC. Harden is an excellent and a willing passer. If you just look at his assist numbers this year, it'll show, even though he's scoring as much as he's scoring, he gives the ball up. Back then, he passed even more because he deferred to Durant and Westbrook. Waiters is a pure scorer, and I'm not sure he's going to be ever willing to defer. It was like pulling teeth to get him to play within this structure with Cleveland. His style is perfect for a six-man role, but he doesn't really like it. It's like he kind of frowns upon it. So I don't know what's going on there. So if he agrees to play defense, though, and to accept the role, he could be a really nice third or fourth scorer. And when I say third or fourth scorer, I don't mean third or fourth scorer necessarily on the floor, unless he's out there with Durant and Westbrook, which could be the case. But the team really need another guy that can step up and score when Westbrook and Durant are out of the game. Now then again, Reggie Jackson has been somewhat playing that role, and he's shown that he's capable of scoring in bunches. And then, so then you ask, but all of those guys, well then what's up with like Andre Roberson, who's played pretty well, and Jeremy Lamb, who is kind of really extremely lackadaisical. But right now it looks like the Thunder have a collection of similar players. So perhaps they have, you know, another move left in them. You know, maybe they're not done, because right now it just seems like it's a log jam here. And because of the log jam that this trade has created for OKC, I feel that Cleveland has gotten the best of this deal. Now, they still have some holes, but Smith and Shumpert, to me, will help Cleveland reach their goals better than Waiters will help the Thunder reach their goals. But that's just what I say. I appreciate y'all listening. This is the news and thoughts on the three-team blockbuster deal. Y'all continue to listen, subscribe, follow, and don't forget to leave a like. Peace.